As you might know, creating circuits on a piece of perf board is kind of a tradition for me when I come up with new electronics projects. But then again, this is obviously not the only way to create a circuit. That is why I already demonstrated in a previous video how to etch a circuit board and how you can design and order PCBs from a professional PCB manufacturer. But ever since I did a review of the x-carve, which is a CNC machine that I occasionally use to cut materials for projects, people have been asking for a PCB milling video. So due to popular demands and the fact that I kind of failed halfway through this video, here is my how not to mill a PCB, except for SMD, video. Let's get started. First off, what exactly is PCB milling? Well, in a nutshell, you grab a blank PCB which has a very thin layer of copper on one side, secure it on the work surface of your CNC, take an appropriately named PCB milling bit which has a very fine tip, mount that in the spindle of your CNC, and finally send over G-code which makes the CNC move in a way to create the PCB traces of your circuits. So all in all, it sounds like a useful method to create prototyping PCBs, right? As an example, let's use the circuit from my Wi-Fi RGB LED lamp project. It took me approximately 3 hours to solder all the components to the perf board and connect them to one another. So the question is PCB milling faster? The first step to answer this question was to convert the schematic of the circuit into a PCB and creating a suitable board layout. After that was done, I clicked the fabrication output button and downloaded the Gerber files, which we will need in a minute. This process so far, however, already took me around 1 hour. Next, I downloaded and installed the software Flatcam. After starting it, I firstly changed all the units to millimeters and then imported the .gtl file of the Gerber files. Next, I switched to the selected tab, added an offset to the design files so that the board is close to the zero point, changed the tool diameter for the isolation routing to 0.1 and clicked on generate geometry. The newly created project file now shows through the red lines where the bits will remove the copper. So once again, after switching to the selected tab, I changed the Z cut depth to around 0.05, the travel Z height to 3, the feed rate to 80, the tool diameter to 0.1 and clicked on generate. With that being done, I exported the G-codes and had a closer look at the available milling bits. Now all of them have a different opening angle and a different diameter, but since I messed up one time while opening the box, I have no idea which one is which. So I'm just going to choose this one for the first PCB milling test. And after clamping down the blank PCB to the CNC, I lowered the milling bit so that it barely touched the copper, turned on the machine, plugged it into my computer and started the easel CNC control software. By clicking the import G-code option, I selected the G-code we just created, which according to the preview screen should theoretically work just fine. That means it was time to click carve and see how the x-carve translate the machine codes into proper movement. And during the first couple of minutes, I had some hopes that this could turn out great, but that optimism faded away pretty quickly. But let's evaluate the quality of the PCB when the milling is complete. And for now, let's focus on the fact that my CNC is ridiculously loud. And best of all, this noise disturbance continued for 1 hour and 10 minutes until the board was finished. So let's free it from its clamp prison, clean it with some isopropanol and have a look at the result, if we can call it that. Most of the problems with this milling process has to do with the different depths the bits cut through the material. The culprit for that is partly the fact that no blank PCB is completely flat. There's always a little curve. To solve that problem, other tutorials with more successful results highly suggest to auto-level the board. If you want to try that out, then you can find the links to those tutorials in the video description. But for me, the actual PCB milling and this preparation with its 1.5 hour time consumption already adds up the overall PCB milling process to 2.5 hours. And once we had the time to drill the holes for the PCB, which is also possible to do with the flat cam software and thus the CNC, and the time to solder in all the components, we easily exceed the 3 hours of my handmade perfboard soldering. Now of course a milled PCB looks better and is easier to reproduce. But then again, ordering a professionally made PCB has the same advantages and is nowadays dirt cheap. So all in all, I think milling PCBs for through-hole components is kind of a waste of time. But let's say you have components that you cannot easily solder onto a perfboard, and thus cannot easily create a test circuit, like with SMD components. A good example is my DIY charge protect boost circuit, whose first version did actually not function correctly. There it would have made sense to create a milled test PCB. So once again I downloaded the Gerber files for it, created the G-code with flat cam and sent it over to the x-carve in order to witness another failed attempt, which this time only took around 17 minutes. As you can see, the problem with the non-consistent cutting depth was still present. But nevertheless, I changed the milling bits to one with an even finer tip and gave it another shot. This time though, the bit sank into the material more and more, and eventually even reached the work surface of my CNC. But the good news is that I found the culprit for all the problems, a loose screw at the Z-axis stepper motor. After then starting the SMD milling process for the third time, it finally worked out how it was supposed to. Before evaluating it though, I tried the milling process one last time, which also turned out pretty good at first sight. But under the microscope, we can actually see that the last milling attempt was a bit too deep, and thus some traces were too thin. The second last milled circuit, however, captured all the mandatory details very well. Only 3 small interruptions were missing. And once I was sure all the required sections were isolated to one another, I brought in the SMD components and started soldering. So all in all, I think PCB milling for through-hole components is redundant. But on the other hand, it is very useful for SMD test circuits. But what do you think? And do you think that the low-budget $200 CNC machines from China can handle this job as well? Leave your thoughts in the comment section below. As always, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Stay creative! And I will see you next time.